now with the Vice President, Secretary Becerra, and Deputy Attorney General Monaco, I want to talk about an executive order I'm signing to protect reproductive rights of women. In the aftermath of the Supreme Court's terrible, extreme, and I think so totally wrong-headed decision to overturn Roe v. Wade. In both formalized actions I announced right after the decision, as well as adding new measures today. Let's be clear about something from the very start. This was not a decision driven by the Constitution. Let me say it again. This was not a decision driven by the Constitution. And despite what those justices in the majority said, this was not a decision driven by history. You've all probably had a chance to read the decisions and the dissent. The majority rattles off laws from the 19th century to support the idea that Roe was a historic anomaly because states outlawed abortion in the 1880s toward the end. But that's just wrong. The truth is, today's Supreme Court majority that is playing fast and loose with the facts. Even 150 years ago, the common law and many state laws did not criminalize abortion early in pregnancy, which is very similar to the viability line drawn by Roe. But the Dobbs majority ignores that fact. And the Dobbs majority ignores that many laws are enacted to protect women at the time when they were dying from unsafe abortions. This is the horrific reality that Roe sought to end. The practice of medicine should not be frozen in the 19th century. So what happened? The dissenting opinion says as clear as you can possibly say it. And here's the quote. Neither law nor facts nor attitudes have provided any new reason to reach a different result than Roe and Casey did. And all that's changed is this court, end of quote. All that's changed is this court. That wasn't about the Constitution or the law. It was about a deep, long-seeding antipathy toward Roe and the broader right to privacy. As the justice wrote in their dissent, and I quote, the majority has overruled Roe and Casey for one and only one reason, because it has always despised them, and now it has the votes to discard them, end of quote. So what we're witnessing wasn't a constitutional judgment. It was an exercise in raw political power. On the day the Dobbs decision came down, I immediately announced what I would do. But I also made it clear, based on the reasoning of the court, there is no constitutional right to choose. The only way to fulfill and restore that right for women in this country is by voting, by exercising the power at the ballot box. Let me explain. We need two additional pro-choice senators and a pro-choice House to codify Roe as federal law. Your vote can make that a reality. I know it's frustrating, and it made a lot of people very angry, but the truth is this, and it's not just me saying it, it's what the court said. When you read the decision the court has made clear, it will not protect the rights of women, period, period. After having made the decision based on a reading of a document that was frozen in time in the 1860s, when women didn't even have the right to vote, the court now, practically dares the women of America to go to the ballot box and restore the very rights they've just taken away. One of the most extraordinary parts of the decision, in my view, is the majority writes, and I quote, I'm just a quote now from the majority, women are not without electoral or political power. It is noteworthy that the percentage of women who register to vote and cast a ballot is consistently higher than the percentage of the men who do so, end of quote. Repeat the line. Women are not without electoral and or political, or political power. That's another way of saying that you, the women of America, can determine the outcome of this issue. I don't think the court, or for that matter, the Republicans who for decades have pushed the extreme agenda, have a clue about the power of American women. But they're about to find out, in my view. It's my hope and strong belief that women will, in fact, turn out in record numbers to reclaim the rights that have been taken from them by the court. And let me be clear, while I wish it had not come to this, this is the fastest route available. I'm just stating a basic fundamental notion. The fastest way to restore Roe is to pass a national law codifying Roe, which I will sign immediately upon its passage at my desk. And we can't wait. Extreme Republican governors, extreme Republican state legislators, and Republican extremists in the Congress overall, all of them have not only fought to take away the right, our rights, but they're now determined to go as far as they can. Now, the most extreme Republican governors and state legislators have taken the court's decision as a green light to impose some of the harshest and most restrictive laws seen in this country in a long time. These are the laws that not only put women's lives at risk, these are the laws that will cost lives. What we're witnessing is a giant step backwards in much of our country. Already, the bans are in effect in 13 states. 12 additional states are likely to ban choice in the coming weeks. And in a number of these states, the laws are so extreme, they've raised the threat of criminal penalties for doctors and healthcare providers. They're so extreme that many don't allow for exceptions, even for rape or incest. Let me say that again. Some of the states don't allow for exceptions for rape or incest. This isn't some imagined horror. It's already happening. Just last week, it was reported that a 10-year-old girl was a rape victim in Ohio, 10 years old. And she was forced to have to travel out of the state to Indiana to seek to terminate the pregnancy and maybe save her life. That's last part is my judgment, 10 years old. 10 years old, raped, 6 weeks pregnant, already traumatized, was forced to travel to another state. Imagine being that little girl. Just imagine being that little girl, 10 years old. Does anyone believe that it's Ohio's majority view that that should not be able to be dealt with? Or in any other state in the nation? A 10-year-old girl should be forced to give birth to a rapist's child? I can tell you what I don't. I can't think of anything as much more extreme. The court's decision has already been received by Republicans in Congress as a green light to go further and pass a national ban. A national ban. Remember what they're saying? They're saying there's no right to privacy, so therefore it's not protected by the Constitution. So left up to the states and the Congress what they want to do. And now my Republican friends are talking about it. Getting the Congress to pass a national ban and the extreme positions that they're taking in some of these states. That will mean the right to choose will be illegal nationwide if in fact they succeed. But let me tell you something. As long as I'm president, it won't happen because I'll veto it. So the choice is clear. If you want to change the circumstance for women and even little girls in this country, please go out and vote. When tens of millions of women vote this year, they won't be alone. Millions and millions of men will be taking up the fight alongside them to restore the right to choose and the broader right to privacy in this nation, which they denied existed. And the challenge from the court to the American women and men. This is a nation. The challenge is go out and vote. Well, for God's sake, there's an election in November. Vote, 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 vote. Consider the challenge accepted, court. But in the meantime, I'm signing this important executive order.
We spend a lot of time deconstructing the news, trying to parse it into a form that everybody can understand. We try to find those little nitpicks where it flies above the fray, etc. If you really like these videos that we do, I want to ask a big favor. Please go ahead, number one, subscribe to our channel, and number two, please join if you can. Thank you so kindly for watching. Keep watching. Please remember to share. We must populate the entire internet with our progressive message, a message that we know is what most Americans say that they want. So help us, please join.